going to the bathroom.
Okay.
Okay. So, can I go to the bathroom?
Yeah, go. Okay.
So you know, since you raised your hand for me just now, I'm calling the police to let the police know you raised your hand.
Okay.
I'm not sure you wanted to hit me. Is what it
I wasn't going to hit you. I wasn't trying to hit you.
Well, that's what it seemed like.
Okay,
it seemed like
I wasn't
it was
doing
violence.
That.
It
that's
seemed
not
like
what
it was
I did.
Violence was
okay,
going on.
But it's not violence. I wasn't doing
then
it.
Then why'd you raise your hand?
I didn't raise. I was going to the bathroom.
But you did just like that.
That's not what happened.
That's not what happened.
Okay, but I wasn't attacking you. That's
you were?
No, I wasn't.
Well,
I was
you told the police what I did.
I was going to go to the. I was going to.
You raised your hands at me.
I was going to the bathroom.
You want
to
hit me?
No, I do not.
Huh?
No, sir, I do not want to hit you. I do not want
to
hit you.
Well, you're going to have to explain
you.
It to the police
okay.
when you get there.
I will. I didn't do anything. So
you
I
didn't?
I didn't. I.
You were constantly doing
I'll
stuff to you.
Them.
We're constantly doing stuff
I know,
to you.
I know. I'll explain it to them.
You know?
I didn't
oh, you
do
know.
Anything.
So we're constantly doing stuff to
yeah.
you. Well, you just said you know.
I didn't say that.
You did. Jeez, I just heard you say it. You said, I know. So what are we constantly doing to you?
No, all I was saying is that I wasn't attacking you. That's all that I said.
You raised your hands at me.
But we misinterpreted that. You might, but I didn't. I didn't do anything. Like I wasn't. I was trying to go to the bathroom, and then you came out of your room while I was trying to go to the bathroom.
And all you had to do was keep walking. But you turned around and raised your hands at me.
We'll tell that to the police when they get here. But it was just a misunderstanding. Like I didn't do anything.
You raised your hands at me.
I know that you interpreted it that way. And there might have been things that I interpreted that you weren't trying to do. But
what
I wasn't
did I
trying
try to do?
No, but you just said that I was constantly, that you were constantly doing stuff to me.
Well, yeah, no, because you said it. So what was I trying
no, but
to
you
do?
You said that, though. I was just trying to go to the bathroom.
Wait, but you just said those things you interpret that I was trying to do.
No, but
so
I was trying to say, because you were saying that I was, that you were, you just said that I was, that you were constantly doing stuff to me. You asked me what it was.
Right.
I was trying to say, maybe I misinterpreted something and you weren't doing anything. That's what I was trying to say. Is that maybe we were just misinterpreting each other. I was just trying to go to the bathroom. Maybe you were just trying to say something, but I misinterpreted it, and you misinterpreted
it. You raised
something.
Your hands at me.
I didn't do that on purpose. I was trying to go to the bathroom. That's what I meant. So
you're
going to
raise your hand at a person with cancer.
I wasn't trying to raise my hand
okay.
at you. I was just trying to go to the bathroom. That's all I was trying to do was go to the bathroom. That's why I don't speak to you. That's why I don't talk to you, because I try to avoid you or us misinterpreting each other. Because I don't.
Then why won't you leave?
Because
that's
I don't have anywhere to go.
Okay,
right
then
now.
Why don't you try? That'll be the easiest thing, TJ, is for you to just leave. for you to try.
I'm trying to find a place to go so I can leave.
How are you doing that, TJ?
I can't explain it to you, but that's what I'm saying. That's why I've been trying to work. I've been trying to do
You've
what
been
I've,
trying to
I've
work?
Been trying to do my YouTube. I've been trying to get my YouTube off the ground so that I can make money. You can make money on YouTube.
I know, TJ, you can make money on YouTube. I know, and you're gonna tell me this story again and again and again. And what are you doing to make money? You know, I don't even care, because this is the same stuff you're gonna tell me over and over again. Influencers make money. You're not an influencer. No one's listening to you. You don't have a following. People that have followings make money because advertisers pay them for that. You have no following. You sit in your parents' room all day long pretending you're a fancy guy. You're not a fancy guy, TJ. You gotta grow up, but you won't do that. You won't do it, and you won't leave. And I don't understand that. I don't want you here. I don't know how many times I have to say that more plainly than I do now. I don't want you here. Why won't you just leave? I'm begging you. Why won't you just leave?
I'm going to try to find a place to go, but I can't. Whenever I do, like, I'm just trying to find somewhere to go. That's what I've been trying to do this whole time. Because, like, the sooner I do leave and find somewhere to go, then we don't ever have to speak to each other again.
But just leave.
But I don't have anywhere to go right now.
But you're going to keep saying that every day, aren't you? Every day.
I'm gonna try to find a lawyer. I'm going to try to do whatever
I can. Okay, okay. What's a lawyer going to do today?
I know. That's what I'm saying. I can't explain it to you, but they probably can help me. I'm going to try to find someone who can legally help me.
Legally help you do what?
I can't explain it to you.
Because there's nothing to explain, TJ. No one stole anything from you. You have no intellectual property. It's a fantasy, TJ. That's in your head. That's not real. You don't own anything. You didn't create anything. You don't have anything, TJ. Stop it. Come back to reality. There is no one to help you. You know how I know what there's no one to help you? Because you've talked to lawyers. And if they thought they had a case against Disney, they would have taken it for free. You don't have anything, TJ. So you can stop with those lies. And I don't know why you pretend that you do. Maybe it makes you feel better to pretend like you got something going on. I don't know why you do what you do. You sit in your room singing and you do all this stuff and you talk to people like you're on top of a business. You're not, though. You know who is? I am. I run a business. I'm in charge of $38 million worth of people and money. When I'm on the phone conducting business, that's what I'm doing. I get a check for what I do. You get nothing because you have nothing. And you're going to go back in that room and pretend like you're still doing something that you ain't doing. And next week you'll come out here and say, oh, if I could just get a lawyer, I have offered to pay for you a lawyer, and you didn't do it. You know why? Because you have nothing to show them. And I'd still pay for it. If it would get you out of my house, I would still pay for it. But you keep saying.
Okay, so if I call a lawyer, and then will you help me pay for it?
Well,
I will do that. Because that was why I hadn't called anymore. It's because I didn't think I would have the money to pay them.
Do you understand what I'm saying, though?
I believe that I have a case. I do. And I know that you don't. But if you would help me pay it, then I would call a lawyer.
And then what happens when they tell you you don't have a case?
But we don't know if that's going to happen.
Okay, though. But when they don't, when they tell
I know,
you...
I know, and that's why I didn't ask you, because I know that you were going to perceive as me wasting your money.
No, it's not about wasting my money. This is an investment in you getting out. When they tell you you don't have a case, what then?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I've only talked to them once, and he just said that he didn't have enough, and he told me to come back to him when I had more. So he didn't just flat out say no. And that's why I do believe that I have a case, though. That's why I didn't ask you, because I didn't have any money and I didn't want to waste your money.
You believe this, don't you?
I do.
You believe Disney was in our house taking pictures of you too, don't you?
I don't know the logistics of it, but I do believe that my intellectual property was exploited, and that's why I want a lawyer to help me with the things that I can't explain by myself.
Your intellectual property was exploited.
I genuinely believe that, yes.
These people have been working on all these things
and
since
I want
Walt
to get
Disney.
I want to get a lawyer to help me. And again, there's a point in which, like, the fantastical, unbelievable part of it, like, because that's just because I can't explain it because I don't know the legal terminology and I don't know that legal aspect of things.
You don't have to. You don't have to explain the legal. All you have to say is a couple of words. They created Superman. I created Superman. It's not legal. All you have to do is say, this is what I did. This is what they stole from me. I don't understand why there needs to be legal words behind that. I believe one time that my brother took a song that I wrote and gave it to somebody else, and they recreated that song, and we heard it playing on the radio, me and a friend of mine named Joe Fernandez. That happened. There's nothing legal about that. I created a song, Eddie gave the tape away, somebody else made a record. You never explain it, though. You never explain what anybody took from you. So what did they take?
I believe that some of the stories that I wrote were exploited. And that's why I went over.
What stories?
Like, some of the stories that I wrote, like, I wrote a story called Desmond, and I believe that was exploited. And, like, that's what I want to have.
Exploited where?
I just want to have a lawyer.
Where did they exploit it, TJ? What movie did they put it in?
I know. Again, like, to try to explain all of it.
TJ, you don't have to. What movie did they put
Frozen.
It in?
Like, I know, but that's just what I'm saying. You're not going to believe anything that I say anyways. That's why
they put it in Frozen.
That's why I want to get a lawyer.
How old were you when Frozen came out?
21.
Okay.
The character of Elsa is 21.
Okay. No. How old were you when Frozen came out?
21.
You need to go find out when Frozen was first put in development. You think they made Frozen the same year you turned 21? Is that what you really think?
No, I just want to get a lawyer because
is that what you really think?
I have their lines from the and again, that's what I'm saying is that, like, I do.
You think the same year that you turned 21?
I don't know the logistics of it. That's what I
think. They made that movie 4 years before that.
I know.
It was in development 10 years before that. So you're telling me when you were 11 years old, Disney read the future?
I don't know.
They didn't, TJ. That's the point.
Okay. I just want to get a lawyer.
I just want you to get out. Okay. See, none of us can have what we want, can we? The difference is I can have you evicted. You still can't get what you want from Disney. And I tried. And I tried and I tried to be patient and help you, but you keep doing this nonsense right here. And you don't want to help yourself because you want to believe that you got something going on that you don't. Go look up when they developed Frozen. And go look at how you were when you wrote whatever you claim when you wrote. And then tell me how they could predict in the future that you were going to write that story at 21. I have a phone. Let me look up when they developed Frozen. The screenplay for Frozen was written in 2010. The movie came out in 2013. So when you were 21, they had wrote the screenplay 3 years before that. You can go Google it.
Okay.
So they went into the future and read your script somewhere.
No, so that's not how I believe it happened, though.
Then how could it have happened that they wrote the screenplay 3 years before you claim you wrote it? You're saying they stole it. But if they wrote it in 2010, how could they have gotten their hands on what you wrote 3 years later? Because that's what they're going to say. I mean, they don't even have to get a lawyer for this. Somebody can just Google it. You said you were 21. You were born in 1992. So that's about right. Is it? Yeah, that's about right. 2013. Yeah, this is gonna be tough. I don't know how you're gonna prove this one. Because they never write the screenplay the same year the movie comes out. A movie goes through several phases, right? They get the screenplay, they have to sell it. It goes through production, it goes through post-production, pre-production. Then people have to advertise the movie and all of that. It takes about 5 years before a movie to come out. You don't just write a movie and the same year it comes out and put it on the big screen. Hardly ever happens, especially with a movie as big as Frozen. So yeah, maybe you're gonna need a lawyer to explain that, how a movie you wrote in 2013 was already written in 2010 and somehow they stole your intellectual property. You might need a lawyer for that, because that's gonna be tough to explain. And you still believe it, don't you?
I do.
How? Just tell me how. How can it be, TJ? How can it be if they wrote it in 2010 and you wrote it in 2013, it's the same thing?
Yeah, I know. I believe, so.
You want to believe?
Maybe I want to believe.
Is it true?
I do. I believe it's true.
You believe it's true?
I can't prove it. I know.
Say it again.
I can't prove it to you right now, but I can get a lawyer to help me prove it.
How is a lawyer going to prove it to you?
I know. I don't know. But that's why I want to actually talk to one directly.
And what are you going to tell them? You wrote a movie in 2013?
I'm just going to present them with whatever the evidence I believe that I have and see if they believe me.
It's not about belief, TJ. It's about what you can prove.
I know. I'm going to show them the evidence of what I believe is proof and see if they think it's proof.
You don't have any proof. You keep saying that. You keep saying that's the major blocker, that you don't have any proof, or I need to get the proof. I need to take them back to proof. So you're telling me that the lawyer told you to bring back more.
Yes, he said that I didn't have enough. He told me to look for more specific details, but I didn't go back because I didn't have any money.
So which one is it? Did he not want to help you because you didn't have the money or because you didn't have enough?
No, he didn't say anything about money. I didn't go back because I didn't have any money.
Okay.
He told me that I didn't have enough evidence. He told me to come back when there was something more specific.
Okay.
But I didn't have any money, so I didn't go back.
No. Get more specifics.
Yeah, I didn't. I found some of the things that he was telling me to look for. He told me to look for things in my writing that had like purple and blue, because that was some of the color schemes that were in the movie. He told me what to look for, and I went and looked for it. I just didn't go back because I didn't have any money.
I understand how you feel. I wrote Peter Pan. They never gave me my money for Peter Pan. We should sue Disney together. And now they're making a live action Peter Pan. That really pisses me off.
Because Peter Pan was written in 1940.
It doesn't matter. If you can say that you can take
credit. No, I know. I was just saying, I knew what you meant.
Bothers your mother that I want you gone, because your mother still believes there's something wrong with you. I take a person at their word. A person saying nothing wrong with them ain't nothing wrong with them. She said you shouldn't want him gone so bad. What if you make him leave and something happens to him? Well, sucks to be him. We gave him every opportunity to get some help. He didn't want help. He said he don't need help, so I'm gonna help myself. You make my health worse. I'm not gonna have anybody in here making my health worse. So if that means you, your mother, and Trinity gotta go, y'all gotta go. Because I'm the one that's gotta get up and work and have cancer while you sit in your room doing all this fantastic stuff and then disrespecting me with your nonsense. And then gonna raise your hands at me like you crazy. elder abuse or something weird. But of course, you never tell people the stuff you do, because that didn't go into a narrative. That don't fit your story. You don't tell people that you sneak downstairs and take pictures of yourself doing stuff with your hands and all this weird stuff. And I told you that the one thing you can't do is be a threat to Trinity, and you're doing everything you can to be a threat to Trinity. Not gonna happen. So you're gonna have the same problem regardless. People came here and tried to offer you help because you claimed you needed help, and then you chose not to take their help, and then you're gonna lie to me and tell me that those people never talked to you again. And I know that's a lie, because they emailed me and told me that you refused to talk to them and accept help, and that ultimately you were an adult and you didn't have to accept their help if you didn't want to. And of course they had to respect that, so they did, and they left you alone. But you were the one that invited that. So now you have built a record for yourself that shows that you behave a certain way. Whatever reason, in the face of reality, you're still going to choose to believe that they stole your idea for Frozen. When you wrote it, that movie was already out. Because you can't accept reality for some reason. It's like you're stuck being 13. You went to KU, realized you couldn't hack it in the real world, and all your friends had gone on to be adults and do wonderful things, and you didn't know what else to do, so you just gave up living. And for the rest of your life, this is how you plan to live, like a bum. Because that's what you're gonna be. You're gonna be an on-the-street bum. But that seems to be what you want. You seem happy with that. And that's fine for you. I'm glad you're happy, really. It ain't my life. But if you want to be an on the street bum, it's far different out there, though. Nobody to feed you, nobody to care for you. But seem bent on living your life that way, and I don't know why. What would be so hard in getting a job and saving the money for a lawyer? What's your problem with working?
I don't know, I don't have a problem with working. I haven't been able to find a job with the coronavirus. It was difficult at the time. I don't have a phone, really, so it was just.
I ain't gonna let you starve, but TJ, you gotta stop telling the lies, man. Nobody wants to be your guardian. You gotta stop with the lies. And I don't know why you do it. That's the part about this that I don't understand. I don't know what the lies are about. And even though you won't admit it, I know you believe you were attacked with magic. I don't know why you think you were attacked with magic, but you believe some stuff that is very interesting. And I really don't know why you just can't tell the truth about it. When I was a kid, I thought I saw a Martian. I did. And I told people about it. People told me I was crazy. I don't know, maybe I was. Doesn't change the fact that I'm 52 years old and I still believe I saw a Martian. It was green. But I really don't want this, TJ. But this can't go on forever. It really can't. And is that dish in there disposable?
The plastic thing?
Yeah.
The egg drain?
Yeah.
I don't think it.
Can you get out of the sink, please?
Oh,
wash
yeah.
It up.
I'll go wash